Leia here from leiaforsci.com, and in this MCAT General Chemistry video, we're going to look at percent by mass composition calculations. Percent by mass, as the name implies, is the percent of the mass of something. Before we go nuts with a detailed definition, instead of memorizing all the different percent formulas, let's look at one rule for them all. Percent by mass, percent composition, percent yield, percent association. Percent of anything can be measured as part over whole times 100%. The specific percent calculations will be the part of that specific thing divided by the whole of that specific thing. The part gives you the piece or the percent that you're calculating, and the whole is what you're comparing it to, what you're taking that percentage from. The problem is, part over whole is going to give you a fraction. You can turn that fraction into a decimal, and you can turn that decimal into a percent. For example, say you ate 2 slices of a pizza pie. What percent of that pie did you consume? Let's set it up as part over whole. The part that you ate is 2 slices. The whole is the entire pie of 8 slices. Slices cancel, giving me 2 over 8, which we can simplify as 1 over 4. The fraction of pizza that you consumed is a fourth. To turn this into a decimal, divide 1 over 4, which is 0.25. If you didn't know this, make sure you memorize the MCAT Math cheat sheet linked below. And finally, if we want to turn that 0.25 decimal into a percent, we simply multiply by 100 or move the decimal over 2 spaces to the right, giving me 25% per 100. Going back to our original question, you ate 25% of that pizza pie. But what does this have to do with composition by percent mass in the context of MCAT chemistry? If percent by mass composition is part over whole, then we're looking for the percent, the times 100, and mass composition is the composition of the part out of the whole in a molecule, in an atom, in a big solution, whatever it is we're looking at, we're looking for that mass percent part over whole. For example, say you're asked to find the percent composition of chlorine in 35 grams of NaCl. First, recognize that this is a trick question. The percent of something is always a ratio. It's the ratio of the part over whole, so it doesn't matter what we have as the actual mass. What we care about is the molar mass of NaCl, something we learned how to calculate in the last video. How do we set this up? In this case, part is equal to grams of Cl, and whole is equal to grams of NaCl. Sodium has a mass of 23, chlorine has a mass of 35, which gives us 23 plus 35 is equal to 20 and 30 is 50, 5 and 3 is 8, 58 grams per mole. In this case, we only need grams, not grams per mole, because they're going to cancel. If we wrote grams per mole or grams per gram, they'd cancel. Our final answer for percent of anything is unitless because it's a ratio of the same thing. They cancel each other out. What we do know is chlorine has a mass of 35, sodium chloride has a mass of 58, and then we just divide 35 over 58. Question is, how do you divide this without a calculator? This is where you can try a lot of different things, rounding, changing the numbers. Just make sure you don't go too crazy so your numbers aren't too far off. To round here might give us too much of a rounding error, but let's try it. We can round 35 down to 30 and 58 up to 60, which gives me approximately 30 over 60, which is 0.5, knowing that we rounded 35 down way more than we rounded 58 up. So let's assume we're just looking at a rounding error of the numerator being too small, making our answer too small so that it's something greater than 0.5. Another trick I like to do when we have a number like 35 and the other number is very close to a solid or even unit of 10 is to do a go-between. If we look at 35 over 60, which is a little tricky, we can say 30 over 60 is equal to 0.5. And then 40 over 60, which is 4 over 6, 2 over 3, or 0.67. Our answer would be somewhere in between 0.5 and 0.67. So let's split the difference and go with 0.58. And again, it's close enough. On the MCAT, close enough is good enough. On the calculator, 35 over 58 is equal to 0.6, which, as we said, is greater than 0.5, or pretty close to 0.58. This gives us a decimal, not a percent. So our answer would be around 50 to 60%, or using this version, we can say 58%. So what does this tell us? The percent composition of chlorine in NaCl is 58%. The fact that it's 35 grams doesn't tell us anything unless we specifically wanted the mass of chlorine in 35 grams of NaCl. To do that, you go a different route. You find the number of moles in 35 grams of NaCl, and the number of moles NaCl equals the moles of Cl, completely different calculation. We already hinted at this type of math in the empirical formula video earlier in this series. This is very important. If you're trying to find the percent composition of something when the empirical formula is much smaller than the molecular formula. Say you're asked to find the percent composition of each atom in glucose. We know that glucose is C6H12O6, and by now you should also know that that is equal to 180 grams per mole. To find the percent composition of each, we'd have to set it up as part over whole times 100%, where the part is the specific atom in question, and the whole would be glucose. To find the percent of carbon, we'd need the grams of carbon over the grams of glucose. For hydrogen, we need the grams of hydrogen divided by the grams of glucose. For oxygen, we need grams of oxygen divided by grams of glucose. Then multiply each one by 100%, and this is where it gets tedious. Grams of carbon would be the molar mass of 6 carbon atoms, which would be 6 times 12, or 72 grams over 180. 12 hydrogen would be 12 grams over 180. For oxygen, we have 6 for a mass of 96 over 180. Do you see how this math can get very tedious very fast? But what if you remember that all we're looking for is a ratio? It's simply the ratio of carbon to glucose, hydrogen to glucose, and oxygen to glucose. And who said we had to use the molecular formula? Isn't the empirical formula the same exact ratio as the molecular formula, but in a smaller value? Absolutely. So let's find the empirical formula.
The greatest common factor is 6.
So we divide everything by 6, giving me C1H2O, CH2O. Now we simply set it up using the empirical formula mass. That means we have 1 carbon at 12 grams, plus 2 hydrogen at 2 grams, plus 1 oxygen at 16 grams, for a total of 12 and 2 is 14, and 16 is 30. 30 grams per mole is the empirical formula weight. So let's set this up. Carbon is equal to 12 over 30. Hydrogen is equal to 2 over 30, and oxygen is equal to 16 over 30. Let's divide. 12 over 30 without a calculator is tricky, but what if we take 6 out of the numerator and denominator? 12 divided by 6 is 2, 30 divided by 6 is 5, and this is a number you may not recognize that you do know. You need to know the value of the fraction 1 over 5, which is 0.2. And 2 times 1 over 5 is 0.4. 2 of 30 is simplified to 1 over 15. This is a fraction you should have memorized from the MCAT Math cheat sheet linked below, which is equal to 0.07. 16 over 30 is another tricky one. There aren't any good numbers to pull out except for 2. But what if we estimate 16 over 30 at about 15 over 30, which is equal to 1/2, or 0.5? The calculator gives us 0.53, telling us that we're certainly close enough. But we're not done because our answers are in decimals. To find the mass percent, we multiply everything by 100% or move the decimal 2 spaces, giving me carbon at 40%, hydrogen at 7%, and oxygen at 50%. When you add up the mass composition, they should be equal to about 100%. I say about because we estimated and rounded, but 40 and 7 is 47 and 50 is 97. 97 is close enough to 100%. Now that we've seen the empirical formula, do you want to try this math without a calculator? I didn't think so. So I'm going to grab the numbers from the calculator real quick just to show you that they're pretty much the same. Doing this with a calculator, we have 40%, same as what we got, 6.7%, close enough to 7, 53%, close enough to 50, and we're good to go. For even more practice on questions like this, first, give the video a thumbs up, then go to the MCAT Reactions and Stoichiometry quiz on my website, which you can find along with this entire video series, layerforsci.com/reactions.